Exactpro is an independent software testing services provider for financial market infrastructures, delivering industry-recognized expertise and bespoke solutions for automation and testing to exchanges, post-trade platforms, and banks across 20 countries. The firm also facilitates a variety of large-scale transformation programs related to DLT and cloud implementations at these systemically important organizations. Exactpro's core product, th2, is designed to enable automation in functional and non-functional testing for complex distributed transaction processing systems. th2 is an award-winning solution that helps regulated markets participants stay compliant and resilient to disruption while focusing on innovation and having the freedom to embrace emerging technologies most relevant to their clients' needs. This demo showcases a set of test methods that you're able to benefit from while using th2. You can build a comprehensive and efficient test library by combining these methods. The testing methods we use can be subdivided into two types, active and passive ones. Using an active testing method means interacting with the system by sending it some data and verifying the response, while using a passive method implies gathering data and analyzing it to get insights. Let's take a look at each method in more detail. In this demo, we use a linear test scenario that describes a set of actions performed against the system. To check the responses from the system, we use two different types of test oracles. The first one is a hard-coded expected results scripted by the software engineer. In the script, we specify the messages that we expect to receive from the system in response to the actions in our scenario. The engineer has to describe the contents of every expected message. The second type of oracle that we use in this demo is based on the algorithmic model of the system under test. The algorithmic model, written by software engineers, generates the expected behavior for a combination of inbound actions. And th2 components are comparing the observed messages from the system under test against the prediction of the algorithmic model. In active testing, the script interacts with the system in real time, sending requests and verifying responses. Let's now move on to the passive testing method, which, in contrast, uses data from other testing activities to monitor system behavior after those activities have taken place. Passive checks are the center of this approach, which we will illustrate with two examples. One is Book Checker, a tool that checks the consistency of the market data stream. And the other one, Recon, which allows us to perform various roles for the reconciliation of various outputs from the exchange. For all test methods we employ, we collect all test data generated as we run the tools into the Cradle database. Modern data mining techniques can be used for efficient investigation of the test results of complex test libraries. This overview schema aims to illustrate the multiple th2 components, allowing us to leverage different testing methods in order to create our test library. Now, let us dive deeper into the actual implementations based on using each of those two types of test oracles. The th2 framework enables a flexible, fast, simple, and efficient way for software engineers to script the expected outcomes. The framework combines the power of modern programming languages like Python or Java and business-oriented API to perform actions or verifications via many connections simultaneously. In this example, we define the logic of the test in exampleinputs.py, and in dataforTest.py, we define various input parameters to test different permutations. After the execution, test events, along with the verification results and the message flow, will show up in the th2 interface. Moving on to using an algorithmic model to generate the expected outcome. In this demo, we use a simplified model of the exchange capable of predicting the outbound messages based on the provided inbound actions. The model is written in Python and consists of several parts. The first part is the logic part. This is where all exchange rules can be described. These include the matching algorithm, order validations, sessions, monitoring mechanisms. The second part is the interface part, which is related to a specific protocol, fix, each, native or binary, downstream, etc. The third part is reference data, which contains information about different entities used in our tests, such as users, firms, instruments, and other specific parameters. As input, the model can use a spreadsheet complete with data featuring a list of actions with the corresponding attributes. As a result of model execution, th2 generates various reports for detailed analysis. The full content of your selected messages can be inspected in a separate tab within the test framework UI, the Messages tab. Let's now move on to the rule-based checking examples. Let's first see how the th2 framework can be used to perform reconciliation tests. Reconciliation testing is used to ensure the consistency between two different transactional data streams. Its main goal is to validate that each request has its corresponding response with proper data. As input, we can use the results of different test activities, exploratory testing, functional and non-functional testing, random load, and others. In our case, we are connecting to the system using the order entry fix protocol and pushing various transactions to mimic participants on the trading platform. The data is being captured and then parsed by the related codec. When the data is parsed, it can be used by the reconciliation or recon component, which is responsible for the rule-based checking method within the th2 framework. Let's look into the reconciliation rules in more detail. The rules for the demo were written in Python. Let's look at our checks in detail. In our rule, we're checking if there's an acknowledgement for each new order single pushed to the system, that is, if there's a corresponding execution report. The messages will be matched by a set of unique criteria, in our case, client order ID, side, and symbol. In addition, the test framework checks the content of these messages, verifying that the values in the responses from the system correlate with the respective values from the request sent. As a result, th2 generates various reports for detailed analysis. Report Viewer is a web-based UI for th2 reports. It consists of events and messages that were stored in Cradle, our test data lake, during test executions. Events are the logs of the test tool's work, and messages are the logs of the low-level protocol interactions with the system under test. The recon component generates a root event corresponding to the reconciliation test, which will contain all the related events. Each event generated by the th2 recon component consists of a pair of messages linked by a unique key. In the demo example, it's client order ID. Just like before, the full content of the linked messages can be inspected separately in the Messages tab. Now, let's review another rule-based test component, Book Checker. It's very important to have consistent, proper, and well-formed market data. That's why Book Checker is mainly focused on market data consistency checks. To validate a market data flow, it builds the entire order book. This allows it to perform different tests related not only to specific messages, but also to the order book itself, checks for crossed or locked books, order position checks, comparing market data snapshots, etc. Just like in the recon case, Book Checker can verify messages generated by any test activity, such as exploratory testing, functional and non-functional testing, random load, and others. To get the market data messages in our demo example, we're connecting to the market data gateway each interface. Then, the information is decoded by the corresponding codec and can be used by the Book Checker component. As a result, Book Checker can build the entire snapshot of the order book, which can be used for our checks and provide corresponding statistics. Thanks to th2's feature of keeping a unified storage for all test data, there's an ability to also analyze the results after the test execution happens. Using th2 data services, the data, both messages and events, stored in the th2 data lake can be additionally analyzed. For instance, the data can be aggregated into the respective stats, graphs, or charts for easy test report generation. Information about the available events, either passed or failed, can highlight if there are any gaps in the coverage of the executed tests. Analysis can also provide information about the nature of inputs, permutations used in the tests, the number of messages, their types, and so on. For the purposes of the demo, we extracted all the events produced by the linear test scripts to see which messages they process to analyze the coverage. This brings us to the end of our demo on testing methods that can be used with th2. We appreciate your attention and thank you for watching. The test libraries and tools Exactpro has developed over the years apply to various business contexts, from regulated markets to MTFs, from dark pools to clearing houses and brokerage systems. They've been successfully implemented in a wide range of technical and middleware infrastructures. Modern exchange platforms are highly sophisticated by design and require continuous testing to ensure their resilience. Our deliberate practice of software testing approach is based on modeling the system under test. This allows us to create test libraries that serve as an executable specification for such highly complex platforms. This is a systematic effort focused on achieving the specific goal of improving performance. Some of the key contributors to our success as a company include relentless learning from the most challenging transformational projects in the industry, adherence to our industry-proven principles of software testing, as well as staying focused on providing the necessary growth opportunities for our people. Get in touch with us via email or visit our website to learn more about Exactpro services, and do follow us on social media for the announcements of in-person events we will participate in the next few months.